Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne. Wasn't intending on making a video today because I am starting to work on Jaguar Pack 4 from Agora Models. That video is going to be out on the channel next week. But the reputation it has for the spokes in the car is unbelievable. And I thought I'm going to stop the scaring myself and stuff by tackling just that stage this morning, seeing how we get on. Now this video will be incorporated in the whole Agora Pack 4 video when I do that next week. That's probably going to be on the channel on Tuesday or Wednesday. There is still more spokes to put in stage 25. There's only 12 in each ring though, rather than what we've just had done. But as you can see, I've managed to get these all in. And I thought it'd be fun to actually just show you how I did the start of that. And then we just got a little speed build. So a nice quick video today, but just to show you how I got on with the spokes for the Jaguar E-Type. So this is what the infamous Stage 24 looks like. We've got the rims here and we've got the spokes. So let's see how hard this actually is. Good thing is, look, they provided us with some tweezers here. So as you can see, we've got some rims. We've got the inner for the rim there. We've got a jig, which is going to help us to mount this. I need to make sure that this hole here, or this lug here, is pointing towards me. Got some screws, and then we've got hundreds and hundreds of spokes. All these spokes are the same size, but they're going to go in a different way, if that makes sense. And the first thing we do is going to take this center. This is all metal, this is. As the back there, you can see we've got a little notch in the middle there. That notch is going to match the notch that we've got on this center spindle here. So line it up, make sure that's fitting perfectly over that. So that's unable to move at the moment now. Now we've got the outer looking like this. This is plastic. And as you can see, at the bottom, we've got a hole. That's going to align with the lug that I pointed out on that jig. So I'll get that put in, make sure that that's fully into the hole, just like that. Now this is where having magnifying glasses is going to come into its own. We're going to need these because we're going to start putting the spokes in. So this is what the spoke looks like. Now it has got two ends. You've got a flat head on one side, and on the other side you've got a hook. It's the hook that's going to go on the outer side of this, and the flat end is going to go on the inner side. In a similar fashion, you can see two rows of circles in there. Now the first row on top is the outer. The second row right on the bottom, there's the inner. It's the inner that we're going to start with first. So what we're going to do is we want the hook to be facing to the left or anti-clockwise, and we're going to thread that through one of the holes in the inner ring, not the one on top, the inner ring. When that's in, pull it through. And then we're going to be attaching that to one of the spindles on the outside. Now, the spindles on the outside have got teeth in them. You've got narrow teeth and you've got thick teeth. It needs to go around one of the ones with the thick or the wide teeth. And it should fit quite comfortably in there. If you're unsure which one to put it into, just keep trying them in every single wide tooth section here until you get it perfectly fit into one. The one next one along is far too far away, so it can't reach. And this one here, it actually comes, it can't even go in. It's actually to the tight edge there. Now, I don't want that falling out. Now, I've heard rumors of using double-sided sticky tape. I'm actually going to use glue, but I'm not using vast quantities of it. I'm going to be using the most tiniest speck that you've ever seen. That's why I'm applying it with this. So now I know where that's going to go. It's going to lift that off a second. Put some glue just on the hook there. Put it back in. And there we go. That's the first one in. So we're going to do a similar thing on the second one. Now this, again, it wraps around the larger, it's probably best to look at the picture, the larger tooth. Again, put this on the inner one. then feed it through. And as you can see, that's two in there. And guess what? We're going to do the same thing all the way around. And there you go, as you can see, the first lot of spokes are in place. Pretty happy. It actually got a lot easier towards the end. Once you figure out where they go, it's not too bad, but that's the first row in place. So we're going to do the second row now. So the second row are going to be going into the top row of holes, the top ring. And when I've got one in, it's going to be facing the opposite direction to what the other ones were. So it looks kind of like that. I haven't put any glue on here, so I'm going to do that now, just so I can hold that into place. It's still going around the wide tooth, but it should look just like that. I don't know if you can see that. And once again, we're going to continue that all the way around. And there we go, all in. I'll be honest with you, It's hard, but you do get yourself into a routine. So that looks really good. Obviously now, we want to keep this into place. We don't want these moving. Now, we're going to be putting this ring on this way round. That's going to hold all the nose on. And if you can see, ignore these big lugs here. You've got smaller holes around the side. That's what these are going to align to. So if I just drop that into position there, that's how that's going to be. We're going to use the AG02 screws to screw this down. So that's one, two, three, and four. And then we want to take this wheel off the jig. Now we want to be gentle with this, so I'm going to use a flat-headed screwdriver. And I'm basically looking at the spindle in the middle there, and that's how I'm going to be prising this off. So I'll put that in here. Slowly lift it, and there we go. That is one complete wheel so far. We've still got a load more spokes to put in, but that comes in the next stage. And there you go, back to normal programming next week. Now, I forgot to tell you in the live streams that we had the penultimate DB5. That was last week. I've had a look at the instructions from stage 81 to 85, and there's no way in a million years I'm going to be able to do that in one sitting. So it might only be one or two stages on Monday. It's not going to be the final one, and I thought I'd just let you know that now, so you know what to expect that's coming on the channel on Monday. Anyway, look, I really hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care, have a great weekend.